The world of technology was turned upside down the other day when Sony and Microsoft entered into a partnership. What's going on, everybody? It's LegionOfGamer.com Centurion 1307, and we're about to talk about it next. The whole world went into a ruckus the other day when the leaders of Microsoft and Sony were put in a picture shaking hands together. The caption with this picture came with that Sony and Microsoft were entering into a partnership to improve cloud service and AI technology. Notice that I am not saying PlayStation and Xbox are in a partnership, but Sony and Microsoft. These are the two major corporations that own those brands. Sony is wanting to use the Azure-based cloud server system to power PS Now. It is no secret that Sony originally started using the Gaikai server system, which is very lackluster, as you can see if you try to use PS Now. Outside of having a high price point, the main reason why people don't like to use PS Now is the issues that come with it. There is constant frame drops, you're only allowed to download certain titles, and there is also a huge amount of latency. Now, before you think Sony's turning on their fans, there is plenty of businesses that use the Azure Cloud System to conduct their business every single day. The Azure Cloud System can actually perform up to 600 individual tasks to help businesses conduct business. Sony is just wanting to take advantage of this to help bolster the PS Now infrastructure. They are wanting to take advantage of the fact that the Azure Cloud System is considered one of the fastest cloud systems on the planet. Their two main competitors are the Amazon infrastructure and the Google Cloud infrastructure. Ever heard the phrase, "The enemy of my enemy is my friend"? Sony has already cut off Amazon from issuing digital codes on their behalf. And does it look like they want to get in bed with Google with Stadia right around the corner? This brings me to my main point for this video. Sony is wanting to join Microsoft in combating Google Stadia. Whether people want to admit it or not, the land of game streaming is a goldmine just ready to be picked. Let's put this into perspective. There is about 7.7 billion people on this planet. If you were to take everything from PC to console and everything in between, you would have less than 2 billion people playing video games worldwide. Let's face it and admit it, there is millions of people out there that would like to be playing games, but they cannot afford the console. Game streaming is a way for them to come into the fold, play games with us, and they don't gotta pay the price of admission of buying a console or a PC. So rather than being behind everybody else in this concept, Sony is partnering up with Microsoft to take a leap forward and get ahead of Google before they even come out. Google is stating that you need to have at least a 25 megabit second download speed for their service to work. Microsoft is boasting that their server needs less than this. Microsoft is keeping their integrity by allowing Sony to come over and join the Azure Cloud System. There is tons of companies that use this system every single day, and Microsoft does not interfere with their ability to conduct business. Prime example, Microsoft had to go in and fix something on their side to make the YouTube app more compatible with Xbox because Google refused to do anything to optimize it. You would think for the sake of the people that use YouTube every single day to conduct business, Google would feel the need to help them conduct their business by optimizing YouTube for other devices. Outside of Azure, both Google and Amazon are both known to look out for themselves, so I don't blame Sony for not wanting to use either one of their systems. This does not mean exclusives are going away. You won't see PlayStation exclusives on Xbox, and you won't see Xbox exclusives on PlayStation. These companies are still going to compete with each other on some level. But on another level, they're going to cooperate together to stay the market leaders in gaming and not allow some guy with a lot of flash and dash to come in and basically undermine them. It looks like we're going from an era of console wars to an era of gaming subscription wars, or server wars. All I can say is Next Generation is going to be very interesting, and I'm going to sit back and watch this. Tell me what you think down below. Do you think this is a big deal, or do you think this is nothing at all? Till next time, shoot me a subscribe for more content, and game hard out there, people.